tell you what, Dids, I reckon this one's going to have a little bit of feeling early on. I think Essendon have come with a plan. Plan to take down the Crows big time on a Saturday night.
For McDonald's, Triple M rocks football. The roar of the crowd goes up here at the Adelaide Oval on Easter Saturday night. The umpire bounces it, favours Leuenberger, reaching over the top. Jacobs, Parrish though, out of the middle. The youngster does well, fires it out to centre wing. Collier left it behind. Coming in to help out is McGrath. Got it back towards halfback. A quick kick forward, and it's cut off by Adelaide, and they should be able to go straight into attack. Gee, what a good player this fella's turning out to, or starting to be, Charlie Cameron now. With plenty of dash, goes from centre wing, kicks high to half forward. No mark taken, it was all the Dons in front. Parrish at ground level, he trapped it, spinning out of a pack, doing well. Riley Knight, series of handballs, comes to Rory Sloan, who's in cracking form. Jacobs got a bad bounce, allowed Leuenberger to get it, but he's kicked rubbing along the ground. Jacobs picked it up, got it out wide. Andy Otten, the man of the moment. Otten has kicked the first goal of the night. It's a snap from 40 out from the flank, and boy, this fella thought he wouldn't even play AFL footy this year. He's played every game, and he's just about been one of their best players, and he starts well tonight. First goal to the Crows, Andy Otten, one straight goal, Triple M, Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Well, it's been a fast start, all right. The Crows have hit the scoreboard really early. Big Sauce Jacobs, pretty much straight after that centre bounce contest, sprinted forward to try and just get on there. He's been clunking a few forward in the last few weeks, so tried to stretch Leuenberger there, and some nice pressure from the Crows and Andy Otten. That's an absolutely cracking snap-on goal, and he's been in super form up forward.
I'm going to call it a gift. Leuenberger couldn't barely get a foot on it. Went about 3 metres, and the gift went to Otten. Crows with first blood here Saturday night for McDonald's. Triple M rocking footy. Here they go again. Matt Crouch onto his trusty left foot, but laces out the opposition in Collier. Now Goddard, short to Watson in the middle, has company, so he's held up. Hooker presents, ignores that. This is the kick. And all teams have had trouble with Adelaide, Tice. Going forward, so he squares it. Bagley now, centre wing. Short possession game, Heppel. Still haven't gone forward. Heppel then slips over, gets himself in trouble. Back to Hurley, under the pump from Tex, so forced to kick out. Big high up and under towards half forward. Oh, standing under it and taking a great mark is Brody Smith. McDonald Tippenwoody bearing down, but did not flinch.
Off halfback, he goes long. It's a one-on-one to Rory Sloan in front. No mark. Goddard from behind was good. Off hands now, bursting his way through. Wrapped up in the tackle, Ambrose. Did he have enough time to get it out? The umpire said no. No prior, and he'll come in and ball it up in front of the members here. Very vocal members at the Adelaide Oval tonight. For McDonald's, Triple M rocks football. One straight goal, Adelaide. We've played 2.5 minutes. Essendon yet to score. Comes down to Matt Crouch. Goddard's there with him. Holds him up. Watson, quick hands was good, but they've turned it over. Quick hands were good, I should say. Miller, a quick kick forward. Walker takes the mark in front. Tex Walker strong. He kicked 4 goals last week. He was so important in the big win over Port Adelaide. And this time he outpoints Hurley.
Stoppages look important early already. Nice clearance there from the Crows, and 1v1 forward, and that big Texan was too strong on that occasion. Noticed a little bit of Essendon's chip game that you talked about at the start, yeah. Louis. Looks, I don't know whether that was just Crows defence or their style of play they're going to bring tonight.
Well, it's certainly the way they've started. Tex Walker, you can hear the crowd. He gets Adelaide's second goal. They've started pretty well. The top team on the ladder at the moment. Two straight goals, 12. Essendon yet to go inside 50. They've barely touched the ball, actually, the Bombers. 3.5 minutes gone. Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Hey, Tyson, get a sense that Tex might enjoy being the main man again. Bit of old school up there as the key forward.
Yeah, he had a little bit of space there, didn't he? There's all 1v1s, as we said. And, I'm just waiting for Tex to absolutely... He has been in good form, but I'm just waiting for him to rip a game apart here. And tonight could be the night. Nice start. It's always nice to get on the scoreboard early.
Yeah, we spoke about Adelaide's slow starts too, and they have jumped out tonight. Two quick ones early. Pikey will be very happy sitting in the coach's box. Wooster, on the other hand, stole the forward scout too last year when he went across to the Bombers from Adelaide. So we'd know the intel, but hasn't made any impact just yet. Leuenberger sort of read it best, walked it out of the square. Goddard now hacks it forward, and Danaher in between two Crows defenders marked 45 out. We'll go back and shoot. Will Joe. Wasn't pretty. And Jacobs missed it after a bad bounce and was just hacked forward by Goddard. He's going to have to need a big night with his expert kicking. Now here's the hard part of the equation. Hasn't been too bad this year from set shots, Joe Danner, Tice.
Just need this one, don't they? Just a little steadier.
Got to make the most of it. Dano comes to 50. Gets a nice piece of it. But sent it right to left. And just misses to the left of the big stick. In fact, it just grazed it on the way through. First score, they trail by 11 on the Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
So Crows to bring the ball back into play. So the first time for Essendon inside 50. It was a very good clearance. Joe Watson. As the Crows bring it, grandstand members side. Terrible kick out on the full. Now, was that Brodie Smith that kicked that in?
Hardigan, I reckon.
Right, because he's normally a fantastic kick. So the Bombers now deep into attack. Heppel now to the front of the square. Gee, that's a good mark. And Lever. What a defender this fella is. So back into the side last week for his first game of the year. Started the year injured. Kicks it long now to centre wing. Heppel in front. Can he redeem himself? Not this time. At the back was Hurley. Handled to Goddard. Goddard delivers to the middle of the ground. And the Irishman that's come in tonight, McKenna, takes the mark. It's a famous football name, isn't it? Peter McKenna. Bagley now fires a pass short. Finds the teammate there in the middle of the ground. Goddard's going to end up with it. Fires it inside 50 again. Another chance for Danaher. So off the lead. He's going to play on this time from 55. Goes with a lower drop punt. And this time he gets a goal. Great play, Essendon. Well played, Danaher. Just played on straight away from 55 out. And now they're on the board. 1-1-7, the Bombers. The Crows, 2 straight 12. Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Yeah, nice little switch off the kick out there from the Crows. And once again, Louis, that possession style, trying to kick mark. Once they got centre forward, it was a quick entry. And Danaher's maybe should have done that the first time, just play on straight away and roost it through. But nice bit of play there. So looks as though Essendon going with the possession style of game.
Tyson Edwards there, 300 gamer for the Adelaide Crows. CBUS Super Special comments. Just reckon they think Adelaide zone off a bit and play that zone defence, and they might be able to slice them a little bit. So they get one back, and good to see Danaher kicking straight early on. For McDonald's, Triple M Rocks footy, cracking Saturday night here in Adelaide. Perfect day, and the Crows through Douglas, who's been in great nick, go forward, high up and under. Tex and Hurley towards the pocket, it races, ricochets off a boot. The umpire says that's okay, and we'll get a bounty throwing 40 metres around from the Adelaide goal. They lead it by 5.
Let's go down to Rhett Biglands for Bob Jane T-Marts.
You mentioned how Taylor Walker likes to be the man in the middle and the main man. Well, the Bombers have chose Patrick Ambrose to go to Tom Lynch. Lynch has been involved, the sole target inside 50 a lot for Adelaide this year. So they are saying he's more important, which could spur Tex on.
Good on you, Biggles. Bagley was good coming out of defence. Found Danaher at centre wing. Langford running hard into trouble, though. Gave to Parrish quickly. Parrish in the 1-2, took it back. Now they're in strife. Zarakis went to ground at the wrong time. They steal it here, the Adelaide Crows. Through the middle, Jacob Sloan. Sloan's been busy early. This kicks a shocker. Grubbers along the ground. Charge for McGrath to get back for Essendon. Needs to be tidy with his hands and ears. Goes to Ambrose. Now a cross goal, Hurley. Hurley boots it right out of there, but he goes to Source Jacobs. That's not the best option. No, he didn't mark it. He spilled it on the way down. Another touch for Sloan. This one's better. Handball to Jacobs now. Grubbers the kick along the ground. Goes to half forward. Crows lose the footy in this passage. Zarakis now. Handball to Heppel. Heppel now. Langford and the Essendon Bombers go off halfback.
Yeah, it's pinging around big time. Heppel now to slow things down. Short little kick to Brown at halfback. He's going to get held up. There's the intensity, Tice.
Nice. Nice start from both teams, actually.
And I reckon Adelaide happy to play Russian roulette early on. Stanton back to McGrath. Going to try and get out the other side. All the way back to Hurley inside his defensive arc. Collier is the next man in the chain. Now Adelaide have been able to get across. Zaharakis works hard. Sloan closes him down, so he's going to go long down the line, I think. Hooker it is, in the end. Really clever by Zaharakis. Just ducked out the back before he kicked it, but again held up on the outer wing. Adelaide 12, Essendon 7. Zaharakis long down the line. Big Source
there,
Jacob. So there's a collision off the footy, but Big Source all alone took an easy, uncontested mark.
He did. He goes very short to centre wing. The Crows are running it through the middle. Riley Knight now goes long and says, go and chase this. Charlie Cameron's got the leg speed. Can they go with him? Turns his opponent inside out. Clever. Hambles back to Tex. Tex, great work, the big fella. Tex Walker. He's sold one of the best dummies you've ever seen and got around the Bomber defenders. He's got two already, Tex. Adelaide have got three straight, 18. Essendon 1-1-7. And Tyson Edwards, he is a very clever footballer, isn't he?
Oh, he's nice to watch, Tex. And obviously a quick entry there makes it a lot easier. Charlie Cameron got on the end of that one, and nice and composed there from Tex in the end to dribble that one through. But still a nice game of footy here at the moment. Both teams putting some pressure on. Probably contradicting styles a little bit. Crows trying to go very quick. Essendon are happy unless they're out to chip the ball around at this stage. But a nice start.
Yeah, you got them out the back again. That's their DNA, yeah, Adelaide. And no one faster. McKenna did a great job keeping up with Cameron. But just got a fickle bounce at the end. For McDonald's, Triple M Rocks footy. McDonald's McCafe, Australia's most popular barista-made coffee. Took one in on the way home if you're heading and planning on doing other things. Dits, Adelaide again. Cameron, this time, didn't get the kind bounce. McKenna did. It's actually Kelly. Old gentleman Jim wrapped up. We'll need to be careful here and try and get it out. Umpire sweating on him and says, free kick, Cameron. You stood up in the tackle, you dragged it in, you pinned. This is the best part of this kid's game. Tice, is not only can he run and hurt you offensively, the defensive work is outstanding.
Got a good teacher, hasn't he, in Eddie Betts? That's what he's modelled his game on.
The kick, just a little one. Top of the arc. Caught under the footy. Was Goddard. Got a smother on it. Sloan's in there. Betts sweating past it on a drive wide. Bagley ends up with it somehow. Again, Betts. Hacky little kick. Only as far as Hurley. And has time in the goal square to settle.
So they come out through Stanton now. He took the handball from Hurley. Found Collier in the back pocket. Zarakis runs hard to halfback and accepted the handball. Went to the feet of Goddard, but he was good enough to pick it up. He ran into trouble, so went back to Zarakis with the handball. The kick along centre wing. Didn't find a teammate. Didn't find a target. Cut off by the Crows. Good pressure on Brown from Tippenwoody. McDonald Tippenwoody's very good. Forces the turnover. Now they're away, running hard through Green. No, there's been a whistle. Oh, Essendon. Gee, they were going to run into an open 50. That's a shame for them. And it's going to come back to Laird, who gets it on the defensive side of centre wing. There must have been a hanging on free kick out there.
Yeah, it was a bad turnover by Laird. Normally safe, but saved by the umpire's whistle. Long down the line. And Tommy Lynch, Dan's the tallest, plays on quickly. Eduardo Betts led Bagley. Add metres on him, and the kick was perfect. Eddie to shoot from 35 dead in front.
Once again, a nice open forward line. I think Essendon are going to have to make some adjustments or perhaps get someone back to help out a little bit quicker than what they are at the moment.
Yeah, well, Tyce, you don't want Tom Lynch taking big pack marks, marks inside 50. Here he comes. He's had a big week. So too, Paddy Wright. A little chipping number by Eddie, and he's just about missed everything. Managed to just squeeze it in, and what an anti-climax when the Eddie chant went around the ground. Adelaide's first minor blemish, 3-1 now 19, lead by 12 points. Essendon 1-1-7. 12 gone on the opening term on the Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Hurley comes in very short, and Kelly marks just inside the boundary. Handball to Merritt. Zach Merritt, his kick was touched off the mark. Went through the hands of Brody Smith. Miller at two, left it behind. Coming through Hooker. Gave quickly to Merritt. His kick, well, it was good in the end to Danaher. A little chip to the middle of the ground. And he's been very busy, hasn't he, Danaher, early. Handball to Kelly. Not his best handball. Put his teammate right under the pump. There's a turnover coming up, I reckon. No. Essendon now will regain it through Hurley. But, gee, they're a bit sloppy coming out of defence. Now they regain the footy on the outer side of the ground. It'll come to the middle to Merritt. Merritt now from one side to the other. Heppel up in front. Cameron went too early. Heppel stayed down, read it beautifully in the end. Fires the pass inside 50. And that's pretty good to Collier. Now there's a loose man even further inside 50. And Langford takes the mark. And he'd be about 35 metres out straight in front. They are chipping it around, Tyson.
Yeah, nice bit of play there. Really caught the Crows out on the defensive end. And found some loose numbers for some Bosch tall stats, boys, just early on this game, disposal-wise. Hurley on 6, Heppel 6, Collier 5, Goddard and Zarakis also on 5, and the Crows, Big Source Jacobs 5, Crouch and Sloan on 4.
Special comments for Seabus Super tonight. Langford makes no mistake.
Nice kick.
That's a good steadier for the Bombers. Very nice indeed. They go to 2-1-13. They needed that one. Adelaide 3-1-19. Good game of footy here. 13, 14 minutes gone in the opening term at the Adelaide Oval.
Tyson, it's a bit of ball in motion. Not allowing the press or the zone to get set, so they can't get off and work off them. Just keep it rolling over. So they're always going to be turning and taking their eyes off the footy, the defenders for Adelaide.
Yeah, lots of switching as well, I've noticed. Players, as soon as they get the ball for the Bombers, are trying to look inside, look to switch, go around the defence of the Crows. So don't mind that tactic. That might have been what Mark Harvey was talking about before the game.
Quarter time at Etihad, and it's the Suns leading the Blues by 2 points. 18 plays 16. New map aerial imagery. Thank you very much. Back in the middle for McDonald's. Triple M Rocks footy. Just about a sellout again tonight here. The locals loving primetime Saturday night footy. Hope you're having a great Easter, and they're going to get a 50 here because going against, was it Job or was it Ambrose who's getting pinged for that one, boys?
Kelly.
Going to get marched all the way, the man on the mark, to 35 metres out, jetting in front.
Hurt, don't
they? Absolutely, coach killers. Man with the footy is Atkins. The Rat, who is, Tyson, going to be loving what he's produced this year, really starting to back things up.
He'll be thinking about his celebration right now, I think, Louis, more so than the technique, you think?
Yeah, maybe bunny ears to match Jakey Stringer from last night. And here comes. This will hurt. The Dons have played themselves back into it. They trail by six. Atkins from dead in front, courtesy of a 50. Liked at the moment it left the boot. Home and hosed. They get their fourth. They get along to 4-1-25. The Bombers 2-1-13. 15 gone opening turn on the Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard. Beaumont's your one-stop shop for tiles and bathroom wares. Brett Biglin's down on the boundary for Bob Jane Teamarts.
For the Bombers, their veteran Ian Brendan Goddard just chatting with Zaha Arkas here and right in front of me along the Bombers bench. He's talking about the switch and the open space when they do have movement. He's saying there's a lot of space out this side, and that's how they went deep inside their forward 50. Their ball movement down here at the ground level, still very sharp.
Brett Biglin's on the boundary. Tyson, I'll get you to give us some Bosch stats, Bosch Tools stats in just a moment on clearances. You said before the game that the midfield was going to be so important. Just tell us how it's getting on in there in just a sec. We are in the middle again. Essendon now. Ambrose came off centre wing to claim this one. Goes backwards. Kelly had an area. He was well tackled. Laird came through to Miller. Now from the middle of the ground, McKay, who's played pretty well in the opening three rounds. Tex Walker a chance, but he's got a couple to beat. Essendon take it out towards the boundary line. Getting over there first is Merritt. He's taken a ground. Hurley happy to see this one out of play, I think. And eventually it does go out right forward pocket for Adelaide.
Yeah, Bosch Tool stats clearances. 6-3 to Adelaide at the present moment.
Okay.
Kuda Atkins is the leading clearance getter.
So throw in now. Right forward pocket Adelaide. Otten just into the back slightly, I thought. Off hands. Menzel. Oh, he just missed. Minor score Adelaide. So 4-2-26. Plays Essendon's 2-1-13 Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
He seemed to shark that out of nowhere, Menzel.
Yeah, I thought it might have been a push in the back, to be honest. It's one of the hands in the back. Would have been in a marking contest.
I was too busy looking for a player putting their hand up. Obviously, third man up rule causing carnage. Umpires clarified themselves last night.
There's the same thing in the marking contest.
Going against Hardigan. Danner at halfback has the free kick. As Merritt cruising past. Didn't get off his mark and was in the protected area, but umpire happy to let it go down the line. Talia dropped what he should have taken. Oh, McDonald tipping Woody almost with the steal.
Gee, I thought there were two Essendon frees there.
And a hot ball and couldn't control it. We'll get it tossed in at left half forward for the Dons. 13 they are, 26 the Crows, 17 gone here in the opening turn.
Tyson, was McDonald tipping Woody held there?
They do let that go a little bit these days, I've noticed.
Righto.
But technically, I would have agreed with you there, Ditz.
Righto, the throw in now. Centre wing in front of the members. Essendon rush it forward. McDonald tip and Woody waits for it, but Laird got there first, and he handballs it, well, cleverly into the boot of Goddard and gets the free kick for out on the full. Don't know if he meant to do it, but it worked. So Laird now from halfback can launch it long for Adelaide. Nuggety little back pocket that he is. Source Jacobs the target. No mark taken. Off hands, Collier had it. Couldn't pick it up. Matt Crouch does. Good tackle, James Kelly. A handball comes out to Miller. Didn't know which way to go. Gave to Laird. Blind handball. Laird back to Miller was good. Smith runs into trouble. That's too high from Watson. Umpire says play it on, though. So they got away with one there. Lever comes in. Handball to Sloan. It's a hot footy. Menzel from outside the boundary line.
In the interchange.
He handballed to him, Sloan. I reckon he was sitting in the coach's box.
I wonder Hebel didn't
That's
tackle
out of bounds.
I thought Hebel hadn't come on yet, was going to tackle him. He was that close to him. Hot footy, though. Having to flick it around Adelaide and can't really find a lot of space. Bounty throw in. 26, plays 13. 13 points the lead to the Crows. Lynch. Another good strong mark in front of McGrath. Miller on the drive by McKay. He's been good. Has Tex leading to space. And again on the angle, the big unit is marked in front of Hurley. 45 out.
We'll start from the Texan.
And he seems to, without the tall timber, just be starting that little bit deeper, Tyson, giving himself room to work back and then up at the footy. Such a good, he goes to the footy really well.
Yeah, he does. It's a nice lead up mark. Two Bosch tool marks inside 50 already tonight.
Well, we got one from downtown here late last week. This Likes should be no issue from 55. And he's just caressed it for his third here in the opening term. And he's getting around the boys as he's going to come to the bench for a spell. Three to Texan. 5 to the Crows, 5-2, 32. The Bombers 2-1, 13. Just starting to get out on them now. And that is 19 minutes gone here in the opening term on the Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard. Tyson Edwards with the C-Bus Super Special comment.
Tyson, I just want to ask you a question. I just want to cut in there. I saw this on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay there. You know, Tex Walker 10 metres away from Hurley. Once they win the ball coming forward Adelaide, you can't surely as defenders be 10 metres away from your opponents.
No, and quite often defenders rely on a little bit of help coming back, and sometimes it's more of a zoning defence they have, so they're relying on everyone else to help out, but some nice quick movement always helps the forwards, that's for sure.
Get a closer shave with the new Gillette Pro Shield Razor, available now at Chemist Warehouse. Out of the middle, Adelaide again. They bring it out wide to centre wing with a handball to Miller. He kicks long to half forward. Big pack goes up, no one marked at ground level. Hampton's the best of them. He'll handle backwards now. Matt Crouch kicks to the front of the goal square. Sloan with strength, but in the end, good intercept Mark Ambrose, and the Bombers should clear to the outer side.
Yeah, they head to the outer side. And I think the other one too with Hurley's defence before, Tice, was no pressure coming out of stoppage, hoping for a dump and quick kick in to be able to read it best.
Yeah. Makes it hard when they're running through free.
Big chance here, the Bombers, though, now. McGrath's got it. Tippenwoody's on. Wants him to carry the footy. He's going to get it. Jacobs caught in no man's land. Ignores that. And the kick is sore. Just perfect enough to get over Lever and find Danaher 45 out.
He couldn't wait any longer to give it Danaher. He was there for about 13 and a half seconds waiting for it.
Hard to miss when you're 200 centimetres tall. good transition by the Bombers. They've been very good at it so far out of their back 50 on defensive transition change this year.
A nice distance for Danaher too, isn't it? Just outside 50. Let the leg go.
We've already got one. Joey Combs gets on 50. He too. Last taps it. And again, that little bit of fade on it. Tice misses to the left. Minor score. He's got 1-2. Bombers now get to 2-2, 14. Trailing the Crows 5-2, 32. 21 gone. Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Crows coming short now. Lever at halfback. Goes out towards the outer side of the ground. Risky here for Adelaide. McKay had to wait for it for too long. Goddard came into the back and affected the spoil. Brown's in there fighting for it for Adelaide. Ball loose in the pocket for Essendon. Crows defend beautifully and bring it out of defence through Lever. Brings it up to centre wing now. They're away. Charlie Cameron, and look at this fella run. Two bounces. He's had three bounces. Four. And he can still keep going. Now he switches inboard and delivers to centre half forward. In the end, he was running too fast to kick it nicely. It went along the ground. Bombers trap it at half back. Was it in the back? Umpire said no. I thought the little Irishman McKenna might have got a free kick. But the umpire says, I'll ball it up centre half forward for Adelaide. 30 out from their goal. Ball comes to ground.
Get used to seeing that ditch. That's going to happen for a lifetime.
Off hands. Betts. Betts runs into open goal. And he kicks his first of the night. He missed one earlier. This was good work. Off the ruck work. Eddie's got his first. Adelaide now 6-2, 38. Essendon 2-2, 14. We've played 23 minutes of the opening term. And that's on the Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard. Tyson Edwards.
And once again, a goal from stoppage there. Bosch Tool stats say stoppages clearance-wise, 10-3 Adelaide. We said that was going to be an important part of the game. And that certainly hurts inside the 450 there. Great pressure from Charlie Cameron again. He had a big run on the outer side, almost running too fast, couldn't deliver the ball inside, but once he got in that side, that stoppage there, put another nice tackle on and created a goal for his little mate in Eddie Betts.
Nice little milestone, 200th career goal for the Adelaide Crows, for Eduardo. And I'll tell you what, it's just been an outstanding acquisition, and even though we raised the eyebrows with the price when he came, hits, he's at unders when he first got across here. For McDonald's, Triple M Rocks footy, Adelaide flexing their muscles here late in the opening term. And the Bombers getting a little sloppy with their stoppage work and tackling. A high one to Sloan. How's this guy's form been since missing the pre-season with a cheekbone? Dumps it long and high. Oh, Otten Surely there were hands there, Tice. Was there not? Umpire says no. Contested mark again, Adelaide's way. They love it inside 50. Opting to go back and shoot 25 out, but very keen on watching the Chemist Warehouse replay screen.
Well, the umpires normally don't like the extended arms, and I'm pretty certain I saw that, Louis. He's got away with another one there. Another mark inside 50 for the Crows as well. We spoke about that pre-game.
18, 17 and 17. Marks inside 50 to open in three rounds. Unheard of.
On track to the same amount, aren't they?
Otten, in he comes. Oh, it did
snuck
plenty.
It
did plenty, but it got in, went left at the right time. And they're on fire here, Adelaide. Up and about big time on a Saturday night. 7-2-44 in a blink of an eye. It's out to a five-goal lead. The Bombers 2-2-14, 24 gone. Chemist Warehouse Tice. What'd you see?
Just another push in the back, Louis, to be honest. Got away with another one. Just snuck the goal in.
It's rolling their way at the moment, and they lead it by 30.
Inside 50s, Bosch Tool Stats. We have, sorry, I've just lost it here, 13-5 to Adelaide.
So fairly dominant early in this game. So 25 minutes gone. Bombers might need to slow it down just a tad. 7-2 plays 2-2. Adelaide in control. Umpire to bounce it now. For McDonald's, Triple M rocks football. Jacobs gets another tap. Well read by Goddard, the veteran with his left boot. Kicks it inside 50. Danaher from the side. Didn't get a real good run at it. Crows have got numbers at ground level. Good handballing out wide. Brown, Lever. Long handle to Jacobs. Now Douglas there. Oh, now they've missed a target. Now that one was meant for Brown, but it had too much heat on it. But he's good enough to go back in and regain it.
Throw.
Umpire says throw. Good pressure, Essendon this time. From the forward line, Collier quickly goes to the goal square. And no mark taken. Goes through the fingertips.
Free kick.
Played the chop.
You've got to be joking. Anyway, it's an Essendon free kick.
Fantasia.
Yep, Orazio Fantasia in the pocket. It's one of those where both players go for it. You don't really see much, but according to the umpire, chop the hands. Now he's a little goal sneak, this fella. Improves the angle, kicks with his left. What a brilliant kick.
Oh, nice.
Great kick, Fantasia. Straight through the middle. Gee, from the right forward pocket here at the Adelaide Oval, the cathedral pocket. It's the one they call the Eddie Betts pocket for the Interstaters. That was an amazing kick. And what a goal for Essendon. What a goal for Fantasia. Essendon 3-2-20. Crows 7-2-44 on the boundary. Rhett Biglands.
Well, the Bombers are always well supported in the state with well over 68,000 members. There's a big crowd in here tonight for the Red and Black Army. But I tell you what, Patrick Ambrose is not happy with that umpiring decision prior when Andy Otten got a goal. So the Bombers supporters can feel disjointed with that because there was a certain push to the back. He went back at the umpires and just tried to get a bit of an explanation. We know how good a defender he has developed this season.
Yeah, no, nice work, Biggles. The flag is the extended arms. Tice called it. Said it was a plain push in the back, but they couldn't see it from down there. Trying to get another quick one here. The Bombers to stay in this. For McDonald's, Triple M rocks footy. Josh Green found it. Left foot. Hooker will get hands on it. Tarlier over the top. Ball at half back for the Crows. Laird. Heard a voice. It was Smith. He just hit to space, and Brody Smith with the Jets put it on. Hamble. Back to Douglas. Back to Brown. They hug the boundary line, and again, Knight somehow finds space at half forward. Hurley closes him down. Wants a man to get back to Tex. That's where it's going. Kelly's going to have to get there quick. Bagley off his man. They all stood there and watched, and the kick was perfect. And Tex's mark, 45 out. We'll go back for number four.
Yeah, Hurley had to come off his man there to press up and help out on defence, which left Tex on Kelly. A little undersized, obviously. And another mark for Tex inside 50. Danger signs for the Dons with the big Texan lining up for another one.
And the other defenders just too deep, Mitch Brown and co. and Bagley.
Yeah.
Jeez, he's flushing the footy tonight, big Tex. Four last week, this for four in the first quarter. We sit right behind
Louis.
That is an arrow. An out arrow, Tyson Edwards.
Reminded me of you and your heyday, Louis. Just outside 50, just slotting them through at the SCG.
I tell you what, I thought the big man might like just swagging around up there by himself tonight and just get a bit of me time, Texan time, and that is four, and that is eight for the Crows, and they lead it by 30. 8-2-50, 3-2-20 as we close in on quarter time on the Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Four kicks, four goals. Three marks inside 50. Not a bad start, Dits, I would have thought, for the big Texan.
Very nice indeed.
I reckon the record's under threat if that rate keeps up.
So 30-point margin heading into quarter time here for the home side. For McDonald's, Triple M rocks football.
What slow starts, Dits.
Yeah, exactly. Crows have trailed in their first three games at quarter time and by big margins as well. And have got on to win them tonight. Miles in front, out of the middle. McKenna, short, Watson. Joe Watson gets a handball out wide, always uses the ball beautifully, gets it to Collier. Collier goes inside 50. Gee, the big hands went up from Hooker, but no mark taken. And in the end, the Crows see it out of play in the right forward pocket for Essendon. Deep into this opening term. 50 plays, 20. Adelaide by 30 points. Throw in here in front of the old scoreboard. At the oval, Leuenberger. Jacobs beat him this time, and it's a free kick to Jacobs. Reaching over the top, too high apparently from Leuenberger. So Jacobs now can relieve from the back pocket. Handball's wide. Gives here to Brody Smith. Smith kicks it a mile to the middle of the ground. Menzel! Oh, just a little one-hander if you don't mind. Under pressure and controlled it beautifully. His kick though set his teammate up badly in the middle. McDonald tipping Woody picked it up. The live wire kicks it inside 50. Not a good kick though, and the Crows should be able to retreat.
Yeah, did everything right. Menzel, the kick was ordinary. How good big Sam Jacobs. Tice getting back and helping out.
Big sauce on the left there too.
I know. We'll talk about that one during the week. Adelaide sniffing a late one. Turnover chance here now. Bombers. Kelly will get it. Ground level. Green will have to beat traffic with a don't argue. Did really well. Parrish heard the voice outside. Runner on is Orazio. Can he get it to him? Fantasia now. The Betts pocket unleashes a prayer. He'd seen it on TV, thought, I'll have a crack at this, and he has missed out and out everything. In fact, it's across the line 10 metres further from where he kicked it. What an anticlimax. 50 plays, 20. Crows by 30. Right on the throes of quarter time here.
But just with that passage of play, you get the feeling that when they are going forward, still good pressure from Adelaide. They are doing everything right here, the Crows, at the moment. But Essendon having a go. And the ball is out of play. And they'll throw it in here in front of the Gavin Wanganeen stand. What a good Essendon name that is. Brownlow medalist at the Bombers. So the throw in now. Right half forward flank. Leuenberger, Jacobs. Leuenberger front position again. I think he's reached over the top. He has for the second time in a row. So Jacobs doing everything right in the ruck, making good position. McKay, handled to Riley Knight. Brody Smith sprints off halfback through the middle of the ground. Delivers to half forward. Tex Walker marks. He's a long way from goal. Chips it out to Eddie, and he'll find him with the left boot. Very good kick. Well played, Adelaide, through the middle of the ground. And Betts the chance to kick for his second goal, and he'll kick from 45 out on a slight angle.
Well, I'm not. If you're an Essendon defender at the moment, I think you're asking for a bit more pressure up the field, Louis. That was just far too quick for the Crows out of that stoppage and through the corridor. You just can't defend that. And I'm chipping John Worsfold, maybe giving another little spray to his players, a bit more effort defensively.
Eddie Betts on his way now. Gets under this one as well. It's chipped high, but it's straight.
Not that one.
And he gets it. What a good quarter for Adelaide. 9 goals, 2, 56. It's very good kicking. Eddie's got two. Essendon a 3-2-20. Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
I think you called it, Tice. There's some pressure around the footing. Brody Smith and co. And what Adelaide are doing really well, mate. First handball back and then lateral back into the corridor, and they're just running in a wave. And Tex just waited and waited to the man with the ball. Smith summed it up and then went at him.
Yeah, got some real speed coming out of their back half. Essendon just haven't been able to stop them consistently enough at the moment, and as I said, that defenders for Essendon will be I see they've got a loose, no they haven't yet, still going 1v1 back there, Essendon, so just rely on a bit more pressure up the field.
Tyson Edwards, CBUS Super Special comments. Eddie's got two, Texas got four, and Adelaide have got nine, and they lead it by 36 for McDonald's. Triple M rocks footy. Merritt, the quick one out of the middle. There's a free kick going to go Essendon's way. He's going to humour us all, I think, McDonald, Tip and Woody, and unload the barrel dits, but it will not get there, and we're going to head into quarter time, and the first quarter has been the Crows with an out-and-out clinic, 9-2-56. The Dons 3-2-20. In the end, he decides better of it, McDonald, Tip and Woody, as the boys head to their respective huddles. It's a big night here in Adelaide, Saturday night footy, and Adelaide are doing it in style by 36. Back afterwards to talk with Tyson Edwards and see what the Bombers can do to get themselves back in it. Right now for McDonald's, Triple M, Rocks Footy.